Yeah.
Probably even more curious is right now they walk in the woods and the hanging from the tree.
Yeah. Yeah.
They figure that's how you drive.
Maybe they'll be growing
that. Oh, yeah, well, there's really lots of bugs in them.
In our backyard, I have a pile of shards that I figure some archaeologist is going to try to put together.
Yeah, put them together.
But in addition to that, we have four cats who bring us many small rodents as gifts, and my husband puts them in a shovel and hurls them in the same part of the yard, and the same archaeologist is going to find this all these little rodent bones and stuff. What's going on here?
It'll be about some sacred ritual.
That's right.
Cape Codians.
You kept them in your jar.
Right.
You think of your story as
one. But you're Mars.
Okay, I'm going to ask you how it prompted me, okay? And just remember, your reputation is riding on this, okay? Right. You recycle clay or not. Oh, careful how you answer.
I refuse to answer what ground is with me.
And you just answered.
Mom is going back into the landfill, that's recycled.
No.
No, actually, I have a mountain.
Me too.
When I ran into carpal tunnel, two things happened. One is I had to sit down with my accountant a bunch of years ago to just talk about my business and how to conduct it. And we talked about recycling clay. And he said that the equipment you have to buy to get plug mills and clay mixers and all that stuff means you also need a bigger studio to house yourself, so your overheads to recycle are X dollars. The quality of and I have carpal tunnel syndrome, which means there's usually a lot of other handwork involved in it. So he said, give it away. And if you give it away to the school systems, you can actually get a tax break. But our schools won't take it. And again, I think this is because I live in a fairly affluent part of the world, because I know if I lived in Kentucky or West Virginia, they would not be delighted to get it. But no one will take this. I can handle it a little bit. It's not that big a deal. Now I start a school with 50 students a week. They won't buy the clay. we charge $35 a bag for clay, which is supposed to include firing costs and blazes and all that kind of stuff. And, if I sell recycled clay at half that price, no one will buy it. The same reasons. It's lumpy. It's got sponges in it. All that stuff of a collective, So I got a lot of these, don't I? I started out with a little mountain behind my kiln shed, but now it's kind of a big mountain. And I have to say, I am entirely embarrassed by this. I don't have a solution. I tried using it to fill the holes in the road. I went on a mile-long dirt road that's like the Himalayas. But clay isn't a very good holder. It's a real problem. I think sometimes, hey, there's a whole, happening that could happen here. Right? Not the clay. We could do one of these outside firing performances, and build a new fiber kiln and do all this other stuff. I'm going to make more of these pots. But it is a problem for me, and I really have not resolved it except that I've built this little mountain of it. So, anybody's got a better answer, I'm willing to hear it. Because, I recycle everything. I try to be kind to the world we live in. But we all find areas where there's just no answer.
Perhaps because the quality is lower and, it's mixed garbage, you could use it to make, planters or something, something cheap.
I have used it the last few years to make the bowls for empty bowls. Because I don't mind throwing, that chunky clay and okay, but it doesn't get dead. It won't reproduce. So it's bad. I feel guilty because I've asked this
think it has to be just when I throw like a 10-pound chunk off into the woods, I figure, well, Cape Cod's made of sand. It needs some clay.
Yeah, well, you lack clay. We were sort of talking about it before, but you know, I was reading that you don't have good high-fired clay as in the Ice Age.
Yeah. It's pretty difficult to find clay that'll go to content anywhere east of the Ohio River.
Well, and that's why. I mean, the Ice Age, well, you can find it in our part of the world, but you know, here, all that stuff got scrubbed away, and what you're left with is rock and terracotta.
Handbuilding, so it's not as bad.
Yep.
But when you're one person wedging it for all those students, it can get away from you quick. But without a machine, it takes a long time.
When I was in Chatham High School, I had to do all the recycling. That was my job. Slave.
You're not going to get a lot of sympathy.
But a cement, we have a big, large cement table, and taking the bag clay, slicing it, and putting the recycled, and continuing to work it like that, it actually goes quicker than you think, but it is definitely a practice.
And you can find some pleasure in the business of that.
You do.
Like I say, I once that I didn't like wedging, but I really stopped because my body told me to stop. I don't know if you can see this, but there's a little bit of inward and then a little bit out, and then it's not dead straight, but it gives an appearance of being pretty straight, and certainly it doesn't compete for space on the kitchen counter. So, I will measure this now.
Yeah, you're
going to
get the
opposite
the way I did.
It all works. You know, it's funny because normally, like I say, I'm making more than this. I can kill a lot of these in the kiln. Yeah. Yeah. And the one thing I'll say about it being stiff clay is once I've gotten it centered, I can throw it a lot thinner. But I can't. I'm really not very good with real wet clay. You know, there's a whole philosophy, and I kind of want to keep them up about wet, soft clay. Wrong with it being more flamboyant. someone else's buck, I suppose. Half a pound. But that's actually how my thoughts evolve, because when I'm first making it, I write down the rough numbers that started,
right,
and then I go back and scratch them all off. This is what I really need. But I really have more clay than I need here. The one thing, you know, I'm thinking about that, which slightly pushes in, so this is going to have similar kind of a shape to it, so that when they come together, again, I don't get that big rattle. I just have a little bit of a... And this is going back to the idea of the big gallery inside. Nor does this need to be inches high. All this does is catch the lid from moving this way. That gallery is not made to keep a lid from popping up and flying off there. So you don't need any more than that for that, and any more is kind of awkward to my eye. I'm always looking for that little place where just the proportions are just right. So, you know what? I'm doing this wrong, aren't I? You know, you measure that, and then you measure the inside.
All
right. Just rot it out again. Now I've got right where I want to. So we're going to have just enough clay to turn it out. I was Deepak, I made the outside of the clay, and that's where I was stuck on. So we're getting there. Well, and I'm also thinking about this, because that angle, also want to marry that angle, where it's going to look very awkward with a big gap underneath it when I put them together. I almost want it to look like it was all made in one, and there's just a little, you know, wire line through it, is sort of what I think we're aiming for here. Yeah, that looks very good. Not a problem.
I can't continue. I just can't go on.
this, but say longer and taller. I don't want to interfere with that form. I love that clean line, so I'm putting them together slightly different. Here, this is a Roman girl.